So at NC State University, we are interested in what we can do when we use computers to supplement our ability to communicate with dogs. Our vision is that with this platform for computer-mediated communication between dogs and humans, we can open up a range of possibilities like computer-assisted training, remote communication for dogs in the field, helping people that have needs like guide dogs or assistance dogs better understand what their dogs are doing and how they're interacting with the environment that they're around. We brought with us two dogs to model a range of technologies that we've been working on that really fall into three different categories. The first is environmental monitoring, so understanding the environment that the dog is working in. This is things like video, audio, gas sensors in the case of emergency response. We also have the ability to monitor the dog, so we've been doing a lot of work with inertial measurement units that give us information in real time about the dog's posture and their behavior. We also are working on physiological monitoring that enables us to measure physiological signals and how they vary under different conditions. This gives us a detailed picture of what the dog is doing and enables us to begin to characterize their emotional state. And all of this gives a real-time picture to handlers about what their dogs are doing, which can make them more effective both in the field, but also at home or in service settings as well. The last type of capabilities that we're working on is the ability to communicate from handler to dog. So we are using two different types of technologies there. We have audio, where we can train dogs to respond to audio cues. And then we also have haptics. So we've integrated a number of vibration motors, like you would find in your cell phone, throughout the dog's harness. And then we can train them to respond to those haptic inputs and perform different commands in the field or around the house or wherever they are. Search and rescue dogs typically, especially in the case of disaster recovery, are going to be working off-leash in very complex, very dangerous environments. And so handlers are often at quite a bit of a distance from their dogs. That means that they need to be trained very specifically to respond to their handler's verbal and visual cues. And so using technology, we can shorten that gap. We can enable dogs to work out of sight and have handlers remain aware of what their dogs are doing and where they are. What we are hoping to do here is really begin the field of canine-computer interaction. And when we start to think about canines interacting with computers, the range of possibilities are essentially endless. I'm a huge dog nut. I own three. They are my hobby, my passion outside of work, and this project has really opened the door to me bringing my passion, my hobby, into the workplace, which is really exciting.
I'll take him around the corner. You just put it somewhere. There you go.